O Lord and God of my salvation, I've cried before you day and night. Let my prayer come into your presence. Incline your ear to my cry.
The Holy Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Richard Hauptmann. My friends, the prayers of the Mass are being offered for those held in captivity, obviously, unjustly. So let's remember that in this era in which we live.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My friends, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries as we acknowledge our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, whose Son humbled himself and took the form of a slave to redeem the human race from being captive to sin, grant to your servants held in confinement that they may obtain the freedom you destined to all, for we are your sons and daughters. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, proclaiming the mystery of God, I did not come with sublimity of words or of wisdom, for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and much trembling, and my message and my proclamation were not with persuasive words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of spirit and power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, I love your commands.
Lord, I love your commands.
How I love your law, O Lord. It is my meditation all the day.
Lord, I love your commands.
Your command has made me wiser than my enemies, for it is ever with me.
Lord, I love your commands.
I have more understanding than all my teachers when your decrees are my meditation.
Lord, I love your commands.
I have more discernment than the elders because I observe your precepts.
Lord, I love your commands.
From every evil way I withhold my feet, that I may keep your words.
Lord, I love your commands.
From your ordinances I turn not away, for you have instructed me.
Lord, I love your commands.
Hallelujah.
To his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day,
He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today the scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all who spoke highly of him, and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They also asked, "Is this not the son of Joseph?" He said to them, "Surely you will quote me this proverb, 'Physician, cure yourself,' and say, 'Do here in your native place the things that we heard were done in Capernaum.'" And he said, "Amen, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own native place. Indeed, I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the sky was closed for 3.5 years and a severe famine spread over the entire land. It was to none of these that Elijah was sent, but only to a widow in Zarephath in the land of Sidon. And again, there were many lepers in Israel during the time of Elisha the prophet, yet not one of them was cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian." When the people in the synagogue heard this, they were filled with fury. They rose up, drove him out of the town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their own town had been built, to hurl him down headlong. But he passed through the midst of them and went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So one of the things that we can take away simply tonight is that the work of God is not about human power, but it is about depending on the power of God. We tend to be, weak-footed when it comes to the things of the good Lord, especially when we're confronting other people. In our land, of course, this is not the land of Sidon or Zarephath. This is just the USA. But the USA has a lot of things that it needs to grow up in. It needs to grow up and mature. So we talk about the freedom of speech, but do you notice how words today seem to offend so many people? Where they're at each other's throats all the time? Whatever happened to the little ditty that I still remember in school? "Sticks and stones may break my bones, but names will never hurt me." Meaning, you know, we're supposed to be able to sit and speak. But both left and right on the issues here in the United States seem to think that they have the right and they wish to oppress the other side. And it's a ridiculous thing, really. This is where Christians really need to navigate between the extremes that we are seeing, to really keep our eyes focused on Christ, as Paul and the apostles did, because he helps us to understand these things. He gives us a map how to live in this passing world. Paul, if you notice, and he's talking to people who were sophisticated. It's Corinth. It's very metropolitan, cosmopolitan, if you will, as well. It's people where a lot of people are going through it, and so they would have encountered the philosophers of Greece and the warring, of course. Factions of Rome, etc., all these things. People, strange people from the Far East would come through here as well, right? So he says, "I didn't come with sophisticated words to you. I didn't. I'm not tricking you at all. I am coming and speaking to you plainly, in plain words. So, it's not human wisdom. It's actually a demonstration of the Holy Spirit and the power of God. So the success of this mission of taking the message of God means that we need to be open to the influence of the Holy Spirit. If we're going to be like our Lord, the model of this, right? Tonight we saw, tonight this evening, we heard how he does this in his own town of Nazareth. And they cannot believe their ears. Because they figured him out already. He's the son of Joseph and Mary. You know, we know him. He grew up with us. And they don't expect much from the carpenter's son. But he astounds them, surprises them, challenges them, and opens, it really explodes their mind, because what he does toward the end of the gospel is say, guess what? I want to tell you something really different right now. The revelation of God and the action of God is not for a select few. It's for everybody. And just to drive that point a little home, you notice it wasn't to our people that God performed those miracles in that time of great need. The widow, okay, which was a huge famine. If you remember the story, right? The widow and her son, Elijah showed up and he says, give me something to eat in a famine. And she says, all I've got is a little bit of a flour and a little oil, and I'm going to bake it. Me and my son are going to eat it, and then we're going to die. That's it. She was at her last straw. This is it. We've given up. She threw her hands up. I faced the fact. God, God's not going to act on our part. It's over. And the action of mercy is performed through the prophet, because he does receive the food from her as an act of mercy. And in turn, the floodgates of mercy are poured back on her and her son. And he told her, I assure you, until the end of this famine, your little bag of flour will never be empty, and your jar of oil will always have, oil. Only God can do those sorts of things. And it was so. And they became furious because she's not one of the chosen. She's not. And the Lord flips their world upside down through the power and the demonstration of what Jesus brings. So, sisters and brothers, we don't need sophisticated words in our own time. For those who are on Facebook joining us tonight, good evening, everyone. Remember this. The way the world is today, we Christians must keep the gospel simple. Jesus came to save us from our misery. He came to tell us and remind us that we are going to a definite encounter with our God, our Maker, and we had better be prepared. Let us be generous in spreading a good news of hope and joy and salvation to those who live in despair and sorrow, who are about to die because they have no message of hope. Just this week, if you get the paper, the Epic Times, maybe you've heard of it. If you haven't looked into it, I recommend you get it. And the Epic Times has the article that said, the epidemic of anxiety and depression, and what's behind, and what's the fruit of that? Suicide in the United States. It's terrible what's going on, because people need the message of hope. That's it. So let us not sophisticate things. KISS. Remember KISS? Keep it simple, stupid. Remember that? Okay? to deliver the message as simply as possible, because it is the message of life, and let us submit ourselves all to the power of God. Let us offer these petitions. So we make our petitions to the Father, consoled by the knowledge of his love and care for us. For the work of the church, may the outpouring of the Spirit continuously refresh and renew her and be a beacon of light and hope to others, we pray to the Lord. For all levels of public authorities, may God grant them holy wisdom, a sincere fear of the Lord, to stand strong for goodness and for justice according to the gospel, we pray to the Lord. For those who are depressed or troubled in mind, may the healing presence of Christ be upon them, we pray to the Lord. For those who are held in captivity for no other reason than spreading the gospels, particularly our missionaries in paganistic countries and countries that are hostile to Christianity, places of communism and such, we pray to the Lord. For all of us here this evening, those at home gathered here to worship, may the Holy Spirit guide us in nourishing one another in love and in a promise, a sincere promise of prayer, we pray to the Lord. For the souls of all who have died, may they abide forever in heaven with God. Let us pray to the Lord. Now, in a moment of silence for other special intentions of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
so Father, we come to you in faith as your children here and grant our prayers according to your holy will, for we ask everything in the name of Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise of the Lord in his name, for our good and the apostles of the church.
Through the saving sacrament of human redemption, which we offer you, Lord, grant that your servants may be released from captivity and rejoice in lasting freedom of soul through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for justice through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. So it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol with you all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and
resurrection you have set us free.
You are Lord,
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Ronald our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I will praise God's name with a song, and I will glorify Him with thanksgiving, for the Lord listens to the needy and does not spurn His own in their chains. Body of Christ, the body of Christ, the body of Christ. 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 The body. The body. The body. The body. Prayer of spiritual communion for those at home unable to receive at this moment.
Lord Jesus Christ, I believe that you are truly and really present in the most holy sacrament of the altar, and I adore you with profound reverence. Although I cannot receive you now sacramentally, come, Lord, at least spiritually, into my heart. And as if thou hast already entered my heart, Lord, I adore you, and I ask you to never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Mindful of the price paid for our deliverance, we implore your mercy, O Lord, upon our brothers and sisters, that they may be released from captivity and become servants of your justice through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Mrs. Hauptmann's here this evening for the Mass for Richard, so let us just pray briefly. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle.
Be our protection against the
wickedness and snares of the devil. God, rebuke
him, we humbly pray.
And do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan,